Hello Windows Universe, in this video we will talk about how to fix the error message Windows cannot restore a system image to a computer that has a different firmware. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description down below. Make sure both HDD or the drives are compatible. Incompatible drives might create the error message. If you want to boot using UEFI, make sure both drives are set to GPT. If you want to boot using the legacy BIOS, make sure that both drives are set to MBR. There's no other choice. UEFI goes hand in hand with GPT, and BIOS goes with MBR. You need to learn more about what type of file system you are running on your computer. Once you find that out, you need to create your bootable device on the same file system with legacy or UEFI support being enabled depending on your file system selection. The easiest way to check if a disk uses GPT or MBR partition would be to do it from the disk management window. To do that, let's right-click on the start, go to Disk Management. Click on the drive in question and right-click on it. Go to Properties. Click on Hardware, go to Properties, go to Volumes, click on Populate. Under Partition Style, it will tell you the partition that you need to be using. Reset the BIOS or the UEFI settings to the defaults. You can do this by restarting your computer and entering the BIOS. Now remember that different OEMs have differing ways to enter BIOS, so check on how to do it with your system. Once here, you can look for the Exit tab and Load Setup Default Options. You can also try hitting the F9 key to display a screen that says Load Default Configuration Now, and clicking on Yes will reset the BIOS settings. Once you have either restored the settings to default or you know what your operating system is, you can create a compatible USB drive. The easiest way to do this is use a program called Rufus, and we have a link to it in the article. You just choose the drive, whether or not you want to do a disk or ISO image, download, partition scheme. Once that's done, just click on Start, and you can create the compatible drive of your choice. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.